Congress on the Affordable Care Act, one of the biggest changes in decades. And we would take a bunch of different programs, Medicare, Medicaid, ACA, CHIP, roll them into a single Medicare for all, and that would be disruptive to the system. That seems one prong of this of this critique.
All right, can I start with that one, Chris?
Yes, yeah, definitely.
All right, look, here is the bottom line. In the United States today, we remain the only nation in the industrialized world that doesn't guarantee health care to all people. We have 29 million people who are uninsured, we have 29 million people who have no insurance, and even more who are underinsured. We pay the highest prices in the world for prescription drugs, and our healthcare outcomes are not particularly good. And yet, we are spending far, far more per capita on healthcare than do the people of any other country. So it seems to me that we should be able to do what every other major country on earth does, guarantee healthcare to all people in a cost-effective way. Now, if I'm elected president, will we pass a Medicare for All single-payer program on the first day that I'm in office? The answer is, I think safe to say, no, we won't. But that is the vision that we must strive to.
Right.
Universal healthcare in a cost-effective way, which our system today certainly is not.
So if for people that believe in that vision, right, and I think the polling shows that a great many Democratic primary voters agree with you about that vision, but have also experienced the incredibly vicious fight over a much less ambitious version of healthcare reform, the ACA, right?
Right.
It doesn't seem unfair to say we would like to see some details about basically how do you get us from here to there, having just gone through this bruising fight. What does that look like?
Well, you know, first of all, we have presented to the Senate, we have introduced legislation in 2013, a very long and detailed bill, which is a Medicare for All single-payer program. And it is applicable in all 50 states, and I've been a little bit disturbed that Secretary Clinton and her team there keep suggesting that it would not apply in Republican states. That's just not accurate. If the states don't go forward, the federal government will. So it's a 50-state program, which of course has to be. Now, what you're really talking about is not a healthcare issue, but a political issue. And what you're asking, which is a very legitimate question, Chris, is in the United States of America, can we take on the private insurance companies who make billions and billions of dollars out of human illness? Can we take on the drug companies? The three top drug companies made $45 billion in profit last year. That's a fair question. I think we can, because what our campaign is about is a political revolution, bringing millions of people together to take on not just Wall Street, but the pharmaceutical industry and the insurance companies, and create a government that works for us all. So this is not going to be an easy task. No one has ever heard me say, oh yeah, first day in office, we got single payer. That has got to be the vision that we fight for, because that is the most effective way to provide quality health care to all of our people in a much more cost-effective way than the dysfunctional system that we have now.
So then I think the question becomes, you know, the vision of universal health care, and something that, again, you have put out legislation, right? So this isn't just completely an abstraction. But there is this question of how that gets paid for, and in comparable countries, right? I mean, the fact is, in other countries that have universal health care, there generally are higher taxes, not just on the very wealthy, but higher taxes across the board. I mean, the social democracy of Europe pay for universal benefits with higher rates of taxation across the board. And it seems a fair question to say, is that your vision if you were to become president as well?
Well, the answer is that, and this is an important point that very often gets left out when we talk about Medicare for All single payer, is we are eliminating private health insurance premiums. You're not going to pay them. So, of course, healthcare in general is expensive. We're spending about 17% of our GDP now on healthcare. Under our Medicare for All proposal, the total cost of healthcare in this country per person will go down significantly. We estimate that an average middle-class family will spend about $5,000 less. But you're right. Instead of paying private health insurance premium, in one form or another, people will be paying more in taxes. The bill that I introduced several years ago had about a 6.5% increase in the payroll tax the employer, roughly a 2.5% increase for the employee. But the employer would no longer have to pay private health insurance.
Right.
The employee would no longer have to pay private health insurance. Middle-class family saves thousands of dollars a year on health care costs.
Right. So to be clear, right, the projection that you're, what you're saying is, yes, some taxes will go up at the same time that health premiums are essentially extinguished, which means the ultimate out-of-pocket costs for an average middle-class family under this system would be considerably less than the status quo.
That is exactly right, Chris. And what I get, you know, upset about when I hear, and the Republicans do this all the time, is your taxes are going to go up. Yeah, but you're not going to pay private health insurance premiums. And there will be significant savings because we now have the most costly and inefficient system in the world.
What you're saying is something that Democrats have, and Hillary Clinton, Barack Obama, Bill Clinton, have all created this wall that says we're only going to raise the taxes of people over a certain amount. Under that, no, nothing. And it sounds to me like you're saying that wall has to be broken down.
Well, only in this sense. Look, you know, this, you can argue that this is a tax. But, Chris, if I say to you, let's just say you're self-employed, and I say to you, well, instead of paying $14,000 a year premiums for private health insurance, you're going to pay $7,000 hypothetically in public health insurance. Does that sound like a new tax?
Right.
You're saving, in this case, $7,000.
All right.
So if you want to demagogue the issue, you could say, oh, it's raising taxes. But then you've got to make it very clear we are saving people substantial sums of money on their total health care bills.